Yacone has ruled Republic City's criminal empire for years, yet he has always managed to stay out of the law's reach until now. You will hear testimony from dozens of his victims, and they will tell you Yacone has maintained his grip on the underworld by using an ability that has been illegal for decades. Bloodbending.
The prosecution's entire case is built upon the make-believe notion that my client is able to bloodbend at will, at any time, on any day. I remind the council that bloodbending is an incredibly rare skill, and it can only be performed during a full moon. Yet, the witnesses will claim that my client used bloodbending at every other time, except during a full moon. It would be a mockery of justice to convict a man of a crime that is impossible to commit.
Councilman Sokka will now deliver the verdict.
In my years, I have encountered people born with rare and unique bending abilities. I once bested a man with my trusty boomerang who was able to firebend with his mind. Why, even metal bending was considered impossible for all of history, until our esteemed chief of police, Toph Beifong, single-handedly developed the skill. The overwhelming amount of testimony and evidence has convinced this council that Yacone is one of these unique benders, and he exploited his ability to commit these heinous crimes. We find Yacone guilty of all charges and sentence him to life in prison.